We were in Palmer, Alaska at the Palmer Soil and Water Conservation District, home of the Sustainable Salmon Fund, Matsu Salmon Habitat Restoration. Conducting our first equipment layout, making sure everything is up to par for this year's field season. Going over and itemizing everything to put into a list to make sure that we have not forgotten anything before we leave.
Here we are on 6/20/2011, Moose Creek. Water levels are low but raftable. The launch point put in spot for Moose Creek is down there. Gravel bar that's been installed recently. And the bridge has been rebuilt over this waterway recently.
Last year when we evaluated these streams, they were much higher, so we planned on using a larger raft. They do widen, and supposedly always are much deeper further down. However, the put in, being able to carry equipment down this river, is going to be challenging. Moose Creek, north side of the road. This is all white sweet clover. Some of the plants are different size, but they're pretty distinguishable by their leaves. These are some of the more larger plants in this area. Getting ready to flower here shortly, so it'll be good to get all of this out of here. Moose Creek, day one. 17 miles into a float. Very slow, low water conditions.
See them all?
Yeah, they're right here. Ooh. Just don't move, don't move.
Oh,
don't
move. Oh, they're so beautiful. Oh, they're so pretty. I've never seen them that way before. Gosh, they're beautiful.
Right there, coming out, you can see it as it grows, and then Sierra was pulling what we could get to, or finish pulling the rest of it, and bag it, and burn it.
Kroto Creek flow. Low water levels, lots of rocks. All loaded up. Just pump the boat out. 7:45. Water depth has increased a little bit since the bridge, the put-in on an oil well road. Still pretty shallow. Here we are at one of several beaver dams we've had to cross coming down the river. Just be real careful and conscious of where any sharp sticks are, as you can see. Pretty jagged. So we're just trying to find the most gradual area, and the beavers really make a sharp cut on them. And again, we're still surrounded by calamagrastis and willows. And Matt's gonna go down here, and then we just kind of clear out the area, make sure it's safe. And then We tried going up this way, but it was a much more shallower route, and it went through some pretty thick alders, so we're avoiding that. So here we go again. So climb aboard, we'll search for tomorrow, and every shore, and I'll try, oh Lord, I'll try. Carry on.
It's done.
Guys.
I look to the sea. Reflections in the waves.
We have dinner. Night one, we got some baked beans, some corn, and we have bratwurst. And we're going to float another 5 miles, so we're going to need the energy.
We had. We lived happily forever. So the story goes. But somehow we missed out.
It's the 21st of July. We're here on Kroto Creek. We set up camp last night, and we're gonna finish conducting the rest of the survey today. And basically it's an invasive plant inventory, because what we've been seeing is a lot of native vegetation along the gravel bars, which are a main concern for Metalotus alba or white sweet clover. Likes to take hold in this gravelly type of a sand. We're seeing a lot of willows, sedges, grasses, and rushes in the area here, and some fireweed. Over here on the other side you see a lot of Calamagrostis or blue joint. And the big factor in these rivers is the natural erosion issues that are taking place on the cut banks. And they're dropping large sod particles inside of the water. And what that is a concern for is reed canary grass. So on that bank over there, you can see that's all Calamagrostis blue joint. But what can happen is the RCG can come down, the seeds can take hold inside those sod particles and then begin to form infestations that can easily stem out into the river. Because of the erosion, there's so much natural sediment in here, it's not a very competitive place, and RCG would just thrive out here. But what we've seen so far is a bunch of native species. So no concern yet. We've checked up the sloughs, several sloughs that come into here from farmer, I would guess, agricultural runoff. One way or another, you follow the stream up and you'd find some of the hay fields that we were coming across with the infestations. We checked 4 sloughs yesterday and they were all clean. It's really hard to see the vegetation that's up and beyond the bank, so occasionally we've done site surveys where we've pulled off and we've walked through the grass in just no particular manner, just kind of a random little survey to see what kind of vegetation is up there. And we're still seeing a lot of the fireweed, and we're still seeing a lot of the Calamagrostis. It seems to be the main plant on this in this area in the vegetation community, along with all of the willow species that we're seeing. There is a lot of plant growth within the river corridor, but it seems to be mostly native. A lot of sedges and rushes that are growing in the middle, which is perfectly normal. Other than that, the river looks really healthy. And on this initial survey, we can clear this river now as being 100% native from about a quarter mile down from Oil Well Road all the way to Neal Lake, about a quarter mile up. So what we're going to do today is right around Neal Lake, we're going to spend a lot of time. We found an infestation there last time, so we're going to spend a lot of time focusing on that area and surveying it to see what kind of invasive plants we can find.
Going about 1 mile an hour is what we're averaging. Water depth's been changing from anywhere from about a half inch to about 6 feet deep in different holes, and we have not seen any kings yet.
Kroto Creek, mile 18.